Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna be talking about wardrobe essentials because so many of you guys had asked me to do a video like this. So I'm telling you all the things that you need in your wardrobe so that your wardrobe can be very similar to mine. Stop buying these wardrobe essentials that these people keep telling you to buy. Yeah. The wardrobe essentials, it's a bit of a rookie move, but I am sure we have all been there, done that. But now we have matured and we know a little better. And if you haven't, I'm gonna put you in the game. Now, as part of my research in doing this video, I have watched a ton of wardrobe essential videos, and here's what they tell you you need to buy. Now, I don't have a pointer. You know, I didn't think to buy one, get a prop on Amazon in time for this video. So you're just gonna have to use this stick that was in this plant that, you know, was given to me as a gift to kind of hold the plant up. Okay, jeans, a white t-shirt, a white button-down blouse, a blazer, a sweater, a little black dress, affectionately known as an LBD, white sneakers, plain black pumps, a turtleneck, and a camisole. Now listen, the people who do these videos really mean well, but these wardrobe essentials do not take into account your personal style and your lifestyle. Take me for example. I have not worn a pair of plain black pumps in more than a decade since my like corporate days. And even back then I wasn't really wearing like plain black pump. I don't even wear much black in my wardrobe, so an LBD is definitely out for me. I'm too clumsy for white sneakers. Turtlenecks tend to not be my fave because I'm busty and it makes my boobs look like they start all the way up here. And I don't think I've worn a camisole outside of my sixth grade class picture. And listen, when it comes to jeans, I just started wearing jeans again because when I was losing weight, I was like, one thing I'm not gonna do is buy a pair of jeans at every size. Nope, we just gonna lose this weight. And then when I get to a certain point, then I'll start wearing jeans again. So I personally only own a handful of these items, and a lot of the items on the list, even if I was like, okay, let me go get, you know, white button down blouse and this and then the third, I probably never get enough cost per wear out of them for it to even make sense for me to own. And the same may apply to you as well if these items are not applicable to your lifestyle. So instead, I want you to slow down when it comes to shopping for new clothes, assess your personal style and your lifestyle and what you already own first. We need individuality in fashion, otherwise we all wind up looking the same. So look at what you have in your wardrobe and look at what you wear the most versus what you wind up wearing the least. What is it about the items that you wear the most? Is it a color? Is it a certain comfort? Is it a silhouette? Figure out what drives you to wear those the most. And then also evaluate the items that you wear the most. Are these items still in good shape? Or can you replace them with a more up-to-date piece? Think about your lifestyle. What is your uniform? What are the pieces that are gonna take you through work, the weekend, and everything else in between? Check out my video on why you hate your clothes, because that is going to help you to figure out your personal style if you haven't quite figured it out yet. So what should you actually buy then?
Wait, let me move in the whole desk.
So what should you actually buy then? I know you like those videos that tell you specifically what to buy because then, you know, you don't have to do the handiwork of figuring out your own style. You can just buy the item, right? But that's not gonna get you to the wardrobe of your dreams, boo. Listen, stick around and subscribe to this channel. You're gonna learn some things.